We know how to handle this. We isolate the variable. We start off by getting the 2x all by itself by adding 7 to both sides. That gives us 2x equals 16. Then we get the x by itself by dividing both sides by 2, and that leaves us x equals 8. Now, if you watched those last few lessons, you know what we're going to do now. That's right, more variables. And you also know what I'm going to say. There's nothing new here. The name of the game here is solving for x. Just like it was here, solving for x. Only here, our final result is going to have some y's on the other side. We're going to have x equals, and we're going to have some y's over there, instead of just having a number. Now, here our first step was to isolate the 2x, isolate the part of the equation that has x. We do the same thing here. Again, there's nothing new here. You already know how to do this. We'll start off by adding 7y to both sides. And that gives us, the 7y's cancel, and over on the left we have 2x. And over on the right side, we have 9 plus 7y. And then we need to get the x all by itself. We divide both sides by 2. And we have x equals 9 plus 7y. All of that divided by 2. And we've solved for x in terms of y. And this gives us a formula. So whenever we figure out what y is or decide what we want y to be, we just throw it in here and we'll get the corresponding x, such that those x and y satisfy this equation. Let's give it a try. Suppose we decide y equals 3. Put that in here, we'll get x equals 9 plus 3 times 7 is 21 divided by 2. 9 plus 21 is 30. Divide that by 2, you get 15. Now let's test. X equals 15, put that up here. 2 times 15 is 30. 7 times 3 is 21. 30 minus 21 is 9. It works. This is x in terms of y. Now, let's try a slightly more complicated one here. We're going to solve for r in terms of s. Now let's look back here at what we did before. Our first step was to isolate the part of the equation that has x in it. So that's what we'll do here as well. Our first step will be isolate the part, the term that has the r. And we'll do that by subtracting 3s from both sides. And we'll have r s squared equals 7 minus 2s minus 3s, that's minus 5s. And then we need to isolate the r. Well, we don't have a constant, a coefficient here that's multiplied by r, but we do have an s squared. And we can take care of that by dividing both sides by s squared. These two s squareds cancel, and we're left with r equals 7 minus 5s all over s squared. And once again, we solve for r in terms of s. Same thing we've been doing all along, we're isolating the variable. Let's try one more, make sure we have this down. Solve for r in terms of s, again, we're trying to get r all by itself. Well, we'll start off the same way we did before, we'll just add the s to both sides. And we'll get 2rs, because the minus s and the plus s will cancel, equals, oh, we have a bunch of terms over here now, 3r minus s squared plus s. Alright, so now we need to isolate the r. We need to get the r all by itself, so we have to divide by the 2 and by the s, because we want to cancel both of those out. And over here we'll divide by the 2 and by the s, and we'll be left with r equals 3r minus s squared plus s all over 2s. Alright, we should test this out. We tested out the same way we tested back here. We chose a value for y, stuck it in, got x. We'll do the same thing here. We're going to just pick a value for s, put it in here, get r, see if our equation works. All right, put in, say, s equals 1. And we have r equals 3, r minus 1 plus 1 all over, wait a second. There are r's on both sides. At the end, I'm supposed to have a nice little formula. I throw value for y in here, x comes out every time. I don't have to do any solving an equation or anything. Once I have a value of y, it's just arithmetic. Here I've got r's on both sides. I haven't solved for r. There are r's on both sides. R is supposed to be alone. We're supposed to isolate the variable. That's what it means to solve for r. We have r equals stuff that's not r. That's stuff that is r. What do we do? All right, you know what I do when I get puzzled, right? I think of a simpler problem that's similar to what I'm trying to do. Now, the difficulty in that last problem was that there's r's on both sides. If I had an equation, it was something like this. My first step is get all the variables over here on the one side. Or all the variables over on that side, doesn't matter which, but if I subtract 5x from both sides, then I'll have minus 2x minus 2 equals 7. Then I can add 2 to both sides, and I'll have minus 2x equals 9. Divide both sides by negative 2, and I'll get x is negative 9 halves. But my key first step here was this one right here. I got all the terms with x on the one side of the equation. That's what I needed to do here. Get all the terms with r on one side of the equation. So let's start over and pretend that other thing. Just forget it. Didn't never happen. Never happened. I don't remember a thing. So our first step here, we now know what we have to do. We're going to get all the r's on one side of the equation. Subtract 3r from both sides, and I'll have my 2rs minus s minus 3r. The 3r and the minus 3r, they cancel out. And then I have minus s squared. Now what? I'm going to look back at my example, my simpler example, and maybe that'll help me. After I got all the x's on one side, oh yeah, that's right, I get all the not x stuff over onto the other side of the equation. So we're going to take all the not r stuff and push it over there. We're going to add s to both sides. So what's left over here will be 2rs minus 3r. And over here we'll have our minus s squared plus s. Now what? Okay, over here what do? We have minus 2x equals 9. We divide it by negative 2. We divide it by the thing that's multiplied by the x. But over here, we've got two things. We can factor out the r and write this as r times something. Can factor the r out of this. Need to grab my pen. Factor the r out, and we have 2s minus 3 times r. We can check that, multiply it back out. 2rs minus 3r. That all works just fine. All right, there we go. Now, if I look back here, we divided by negative 2 to get from here down to here. Here, all we have to do is divide by the thing that's multiplied by r, dividing by 2s minus 3. These are going to cancel because this is just r times 2s minus 3 over 2s minus 3. That is just 1. So these cancel, and we're left with r equals minus s squared plus s all over 2s minus 3. You know, I want to test this. I'm going to test this a couple times. I'm going to stick a value of s in, get a value of r, and make sure that that r and s works over here, because there's a lot of complicated stuff that looks a little new, but really there's nothing new here. But it looks a little new, so I want to make sure I did the right thing. Let's see what happens if I put in s equals 1. If I put s equals 1 in here, I have minus 1 plus 1 on the top. I'm going to get 0. R equals 0. It doesn't matter what's on the bottom as long as it's not 0. 2 minus 3 is negative 1. S equals 1, r equals 0. Let's test that over here. If I put r equals 0 and s equals 1, this becomes 0. That becomes minus 1. So we get minus 1 on the left. Over here on the right, 3 times 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1. All right, that works. Let's try one more. If I put s equals 2 in here, well, the denominator just becomes 1. 2 times 2 is 4. minus 3 is 1. And up in the numerator, I get minus 4 plus 2. I get minus, r is minus 2. And I'm going to test that. I'm going to put these up in here. 2 times minus 2 is minus 4. S now is 2. Minus 4 times 2 is minus 8. Minus 8 minus the 2 gives us negative 10 on our left. And what do we get on the right here? 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. Minus 2 squared, that means minus 4. Negative 6 minus 4, that also is negative 10. So now we can be pretty confident. We've tested it a couple times. Both of them worked. We can be pretty confident that we are done.